I wonder if hairspray would work with my dog.
Do not give your dog a mohawk. It's undignified.
More dignified than your little dog walking around Brooklyn in its little booties.
Oh my God, guys. I'm almost on my 11th like for a selfie I posted on Instagram.
People are saying I look like Kelly Kapowski from Saved by the Bell.
Oh yeah, I can see it.
I can see it. Got more volume than normal. You doing anything different?
I researched online for 5 hours and I found a shampoo that works best with my particular type of hair.
Wait, how can you find a shampoo that works with your hair?
Spoiler alert here. Except for anti-dandruff shampoos that actually have active ingredients that prevent dandruff, most shampoos are pretty similar to one another. In general, shampoos can be broken down to regular and moisturizing. Regular ones might say revitalizing, extra body, volumizing, stuff like that. They contain a higher level of cleaning detergents than moisturizing shampoos, which contain ingredients like dimethicone and polyquaterniums that make hair feel less dry. And the rest of the shampoos that'll say they'll do this, that, and the next thing? Sure, maybe they'll do a little bit of what they're claiming, but because they got a couple of extra things like vitamins, extracts, and various chemicals that the industry actually calls claim as ingredients. Overall, shampoos are really not that different from each other. Well, now that we spoiled that for you, let's back up and talk about the chemical makeup of shampoos.
In general, we wash our hair because our scalp produces sebum, a greasy substance that coats and protects our hair cuticle and the hair follicle at your roots. An accumulation of sebum causes hair strands to stick together in an oily, greasy mess. To add insult to injury, the oils make it easier for dust and pollen to grab a free ride, making your hair even less pleasant. Because sebum and oils are hydrophobic, they can't be washed away with water.
So enter shampoo. Shampoos have detergents, much like the detergent you use for washing laundry or dishes. Detergents have a hydrophobic end to grab onto those oils and greases. It also has a hydrophilic end that grabs onto water, essentially washing away the oils when you rinse with water. The main type of detergents used in shampoo are called sulfates. The most common one is SLS, or sodium lauryl sulfate. Here's some of the other common ones. Now repeat after me. Shampoo sulfates are not bad for you. There. Better.
These sulfates are actually really good at foaming and cleaning, and they're pretty cheap, hence why almost every shampoo uses them. Part of what scares people is that if left on your skin, sulfates can be very drying, irritating, and even cause blisters. But they work well in shampoo because once you scrub your scalp, you rinse these compounds off before they cause any irritation. You won't find these sulfates in leave-in products, and that's why. But this hasn't stopped marketers from scaring people about sulfates. There are a lot of all-natural shampoos that are sulfate-free. Use these alternatives because you want to or because you have sensitive skin, that's fine. But don't use these because you think sulfates are harmful to your health. They're not. Many shampoos contain sodium lauryl sulfonate. Because it's a sulfonate, it's technically sulfate-free.
But guess what? Once it's in water, it transforms into detergents and works exactly like a sulfate in the end. Thanks, chemistry. We want to give a huge thank you to YouTube for helping to make this video happen, as well as Lex Fleming from Made You Look and Trina Espinoza, who is Miss Beautyphile. Be sure to check out both of their awesome YouTube channels. Seriously, you'll thank us for it later. Let us know how often you use shampoo in your hair. I haven't used it in about 3 months and I still have friends that want to hang out with me. For more on that, be sure to check out our video on co-washing. And hey, thanks for watching.